classic case of a British folk song that crosses the Atlantic and ends up with death and retribution. And there's a well-known, it's been noted by lots of scholars of folk music that whenever any of the British folk songs crossed the Atlantic, whenever there was any sex, there was always death and retribution. So I wanted to write a song in that style, and I wanted to locate it in a place where sex and death and desperation and retribution walk the streets. So I chose Cranbrook. You know, anywhere on the other side of Bristol, you just say Swindon and the place goes. This, of course, is located in credit. Portland was the location. We made an album called Lie the Land, and this was on Lie the Land, and we went to Portland a lot for the photo shoot, and particularly to the quarries, and the ruined chapels and the legends and myths around Portland seemed an ideal location for a song like this. And there are seven tides every day that wash Portland Mill, so all the mystery and magic associated with seven. And, so this is the preacher, a man of faith, who falls in love with a quarryman's wife, with no chance of gaining her favour.
Beside the water.